In this video, I'll show you how you can program the robot to measure the dimensions of a workpiece without using any additional equipment but a gripper. This can, for example, be used as an inspection sequence in a program to ensure that workpieces are within specs. In this example, the robot picks up workpieces from the conveyor and moves them to a reference point to calculate the length of the workpiece. If it's within the specified dimensions, the robot places it on the pallet. And otherwise, it drops it in a discard pile. The workpieces are moved towards the reference point in the negative X direction of the base feature. I'll start by determining the reference point's position on the X-axis of the base feature. I'll use a spike to make sure the TCP is aligned exactly with the reference point. Then I read the position on the X-axis in the Move screen. 97.43 millimeters. I'll save this value in a variable and use it later to calculate the length of the workpiece. The next step is to move the workpiece slowly towards this point until contact. To do this, I have the robot apply a force of 5 newton in the negative X direction of the base. You can also use a direction command, but using the force mode makes it possible to determine the exact force you want to apply. To stop the robot upon contact with the reference point, I'll use the robot's force sensor to monitor the force at the TCP. I'll create a separate thread with a variable to monitor the force. And I call the function getTCPForce, which returns a list containing 6 parameters. The force in Newton at the TCP in the X, Y, and Z axes of the base feature, and the torques around these axes in Newton meter. In this example, I monitor the force in the X axis, so I isolate this value in a new variable. The X value is stored in position 0 of the current TCP force variable. Write 0 in square brackets after the variable name to get this position value. Next, I'll program the robot to wait when the force in the x-axis exceeds 5 newtons, which means the workpiece is touching the reference point. Then, I'll save the current TCP position, and the robot can calculate the distance from the TCP to the reference point. To save the TCP position, I create a variable and call the function getActualTCPPose. This variable also returns a list of 6 parameters. The TCP position on the X, Y, and Z axes relative to the base feature and written in meters, and axis angle positions in radian. To calculate the distance, I create a variable. And subtract the reference point from the X value of the TCP position. This gives the distance between the two points. So now, the robot just has to rotate the workpiece. And then it can repeat the same calculations for this end of the workpiece. Now I have 2 values, length 1 and length 2. To get the total length, I add these values and multiply them by 100 to get the length in centimeters. The desired length is 5 centimeters with a tolerance of 1 millimeter. Finally, I add an if statement that places the workpiece on the pallet if it's within specs. And else, the workpiece is discarded.